Hi, welcome everyone. In our previous session, we have seen what are living and non-living beings. And we came to know that there are certain common characteristics of living beings. Today, in this video, we are continuing with the fourth common characteristic. It is, all living beings shows growth. What is growth here? It is nothing but increase in the size of any organism. See, for example, if the size of plant or animal or humans increases, what we say? We say that there is some amount of growth, right? Yes. Focus into the picture here. These are pictures of the same person. In each and every stage, there is increase in the height as well as size of a person. So, this is called as growth. Now we'll see few more examples. When we plant a seed in the soil, what happens? Seed sprouts, right? And then develops into a small plant. Then it grows into a big tree. So this is called as growth. Growth is observed with the plants because plants are living beings. Similarly here, egg develops into a chick, then into adult hen. So in each stage, there is increase in the size of egg. This is called as a growth. So growth is observed with all living beings. Growth occurs in all types of living beings throughout their lifespan. But the rate of growth is faster till they attain maturity. So after the maturity, gradually growth slows down and stops after a particular time. Then what about growth in case of non-living beings? Do they show any growth? No. Non-living beings do not show any growth. For example here, I have taken an example of chair. We all know that chair is a non-living thing, right? Just think I bought this chair today. The size of chair remains same after 5 years and after 10 years. By this, we must conclude that non-living beings do not show any growth because they do not have life. The next characteristic is all living beings show movement. If you focus into the pictures below, human beings, animals show movement. They use special organs to move from one place to another place. We'll see with few examples now. Few animals use 4 legs to move from one place to another place, like dogs, lion, giraffe, tiger, etc. And few use 2 legs to move from one place to another place. For example, we move with 2 legs, right? And even kangaroo uses 2 legs to move. Birds use hind limbs for walking and wings for flying. Fishes use fins for swimming. So in this way, different organisms uses different organs for movement. Then what about plants? Do they show movement? Yes, plants also show movement. Plants don't have special organs to move, but still they show movement. Focus into the first picture, roots of the plant growing towards the water in the soil. So this is a kind of movement in plants. Now in the second picture, sunflower plant turning towards the sun. So it is also a kind of movement in plants. Now we'll see one activity that how plants show movement. Keep a potted plant in a room. Let the light pass in through the window. Observe here, all the plants turn towards the sunlight. So, by this we must understand plants show movement. All living beings like animals, plants, human beings show movement. Then what about non-living things like fan, bus, car? Though they move, we can't say that they are living things because they are not moving by their own. They are moving with the influence of humans. So, non-living things cannot show movement because they don't have life. The next common characteristic is living beings excrete. Understand the term excretion here. It is a process of removing the waste from the body. For example, our body performs many activities. Due to this, some amount of unwanted waste is produced by the body. So now, the body needs to remove this waste. Otherwise, body gets affected. This process of throwing waste is called excretion. Major excretory organs in our body are kidneys, through which urine gets removed. Lungs, through which carbon dioxide gets removed. Skin, through which sweat is removed. And colon, through which fecus is removed. With the help of all these organs, our body removes unwanted products. But how the plants remove waste? During daytime, plants take in carbon dioxide and releases oxygen during photosynthesis. So here, oxygen is waste product by the plants. At night time, during respiration, plants releases carbon dioxide and water vapor. Now, carbon dioxide and water vapor are the waste products. Now we'll see one activity, that how plants show excretion. Take one potted plant. Now cover the plant with plastic bag. Tie the bag tightly at the stem portion below, as you are seeing in the picture. Now keep it in the sunlight for 1 to 2 hours. Observe the plastic cover closely now. Water evaporated from the surface of the leaves and get condensed on the plastic bag, right? Yes, this process is called transpiration, and it is nothing but removing the waste by the plants. So, by this we must say plants show excretion, because plants are living beings here. Whereas non-living beings do not show excretion because they don't have life. We'll continue with the rest of the lesson in our next video. Hope you enjoyed today's session. If yes, please click the like button. Don't forget to subscribe my channel to get all my latest lessons on YouTube. Thank you.